हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल चित्रन्ना। एंड इन दिस गार्डनिंग सेक्शन टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू हाउ आई एम यूजिंग माय किचन वेस्ट एज मैन्यूर। आई एम नॉट यूजिंग एनी केमिकल्स, एनी फर्टिलाइजर्स अदर देन द ऑर्गेनिक मिक्स विच आई एम यूजिंग। देर इज़ नो रिकरिंग एक्सपेंसेस, देर इज़ नो फिजिकल वर्क। विथ अ लिटिल एफर्ट, with lots of passion, we can do wonders in our gardens. So if you haven't seen my first episode of gardening, please watch it. I have explained how and where I am procuring my these pots, and where I am getting my manure, and how I am using only organic manure without using this soil or sand or stones or chemicals or fertilizers. I am able to grow all these veggies. In this episode, you are welcome to watch how can your kitchen waste create wonders in your gardens. In this episode, I will show you how I am using my kitchen waste for my garden. I feel very proud to share with you that hardly any waste from my kitchen, my garden goes out from my house. Everything comes here and feeds these beautiful babies. Whatever kitchen waste is there, like this fruit peels, vegetable peels, banana, and this little guy eats eggs in my house, and eggshells, they are very rich in calcium and they help my plants to grow in a very, very healthy way, and they are yielding lots of flowers and fruits. See, these flowers, they are from my garden and I use them for puja, and the next day again they come back and go to their places where they have come from and become food for their mothers again. How beautiful is it? And this is tea and coffee decoction powder. Everything is used. Whatever wet waste is there at the home, I am using for my garden. This is a small bucket in which I store all my kitchen waste like this, just to show you I am keeping here today. Otherwise, I go on putting it in this bucket, and once every 4 to 5 days it gets filled up and it comes to my garden. I'll show you how I am doing this. See, the plants would be there in the pot. First, what I will do is, see how easy it is to take away the saplings and plants from this organic mix. Just for comparison, I'm putting here this one pot in which I am using soil to grow. See, to move it, to remove it, or even to do replanting, it needs lot of efforts. And the best part is, in organic mix you don't get weeds. Weeds won't come here. In this one there will be lots of weeds. We have to constantly keep removing them. And for doing repotting, this is okay, it is a very small pot. For bigger pots we have to depend on gardeners, and it is very difficult to find good gardeners, and they are quite expensive nowadays. This is very easy. See here, this hyacinth beans, avocado, I have put here. I'll just remove it and see. See, chili plant. And I think this one is cosmos flowers. And these are chili saplings which I have planted extra yesterday. I had to just plant them separately in different pots. And this one is cauliflower saplings which I have got from this manure shop. They give these saplings freely. Whoever buys this manure will get tomato, chili, cabbage, cauliflower plant, saplings free of cost. They are doing that noble work. See, once the plants are removed, what I will do is, I will take up a pala, top portion of this manure. See, it is so light, unlike mud and soil, it won't become very tight and it is easy to handle. We can easily do it with our hands or any kitchen tools. And once you take away all this, you have to put all the vegetables. Here also I don't believe in doing hard work, only smart work is required. We need not put it in a mixy, grind it, take juice and all. As it is, only thing we have to take care is we should never put garlic and onion. That is not healthy for the plants. And plastics. The eggshells we can just smash and spread them. And once you spread everything, get back the manure. And this is the waste, garden waste, which I have sweeped just now. And this again will go into my pot. Lightly, I would cover it with this manure. Okay, now I have got some more kitchen waste. I'll continue to show you how I'm using it. I'll take some more manure from this pot. Here I have taken out the plants which I was having in this pot and taken out almost half of the manure from the pot. This entire kitchen waste, whatever I am having, I'll just pour it inside this. It consists of all the fruit peels, vegetable peels, eggshells, greens, the coffee decoction powder, everything, whatever wet waste is there in my kitchen, I'm putting in my bucket here. And this one, I'll mix here in this pot. And after that, I'll put back all my manure here. Once it is poured in, I'll press it lightly. It should not be very tight, but it should not be very loose also. If you keep it very loose, then the plants will not grow. You can press it like this. This is how I cover it, I press it lightly. And then I'll put back my chili saplings. In this one I'm growing chili plants, that's why I'm taking this one, showing with this particular pot. If you are doing this for a bigger pot with a bigger plant, you had to do the way we are doing repotting. We have to take out the entire plant outside, loosen the manure, put in all the kitchen waste, press it, then put the plant inside, this way. See, this one is hyacinth beans, aurikai. This one I put, and we have to press it. If you don't press it properly, it won't grow. You should not leave it lightly. See, like this. This way, you put it inside, tighten the soil around it, and press it. Be it a small sapling or bigger plant or even your tree, we have to press it tightly. This way you can put back all the plants, saplings, whatever you have taken out, and see, it has covered up to this point now, almost 50%, but still I can easily move it around. When we are doing it for a bigger grown plant, the plant which has already grown a lot, for them also we have to put the manure like this. Kitchen waste we have to use for them, and we have to take out the plant carefully because the plant has grown a lot, and we should not harm the roots. Loosen the soil all around it and lift the plant and fill the bucket with the kitchen waste, taking care that the root is not harmed, and then carefully we have to put back the plant inside the bucket, and whatever kitchen waste, this manure we have taken out from the pot, can be refilled again back into the pot. The plant has to be carefully kept in the center of the pot, and the manure, whatever we have taken out from that bucket, we have to put it all around, taking care to see that the roots are not harmed. And if there need be, we can use some extra manure also to see that the plant is held tightly inside the bucket. And we have to be very careful when, since the plant has grown, it has to absorb the shock. We have to press the manure carefully all around and see that it holds tightly. I had to press it hard so that it stands properly. And water it. I am having so many pots, you see. Once I fill in a particular pot, by the time its turn comes, it would be minimum 50-60 days. So naturally by then, the earlier kitchen waste, whatever I have put in the pot, they would have become, it would have become manure again. I'll show you in one pot, wait. See here, in this particular pot, I must have put the kitchen waste inside about a month ago. And now, I'll show you. See, it won't become hard. And whatever I have put inside, it's turned into manure again. Okay friends, thanks for watching this video. Please like, comment, share, and give your feedback and your opinions about my channel, my video, my garden, my plants. It gives me immense pleasure when people appreciate my babies, give their feedbacks, and it helps me a lot to improve. And please come back again, where I will share with you another beautiful section of my garden, and give some more tips and tricks about growing these beautiful plants and flowers from here. To there. Sky is the limit. Thank you.